हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल एंड वेलकम टू द न्यू वीडियो। आज के वीडियो में हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं मिनिमलिस्ट का मल्टी वाइटमिन एसपीएफ 50 एंड एसपीएफ 60 सनस्क्रीन। मैं आपके साथ इन दोनों सनस्क्रीन का कंपैरिजन करने वाली हूं। हम डिटेल में इंग्रेडिएंट लिस्ट के बारे में जानेंगे, कौन से स्किन टाइप के लिए ये सनस्क्रीन बेस्ट हैं वो डिस्कस करने वाले हैं। तो चलिए वीडियो में चलते हैं। सो गाइज, बिफोर मैं ये सनस्क्रीन का कंपैरिजन करूं, मैं आपको डिफरेंस बताऊं। आई लाइक टू मेंशन सम ऑफ द कॉमन पॉइंट्स जो दोनों सनस्क्रीन में कॉमन है, राइट। एक्चुअली बोथ ऑफ द सनस्क्रीन आर हाइब्रिड सनस्क्रीन। इन अ हाइब्रिड सनस्क्रीन देयर इज बोथ ऑर्गेनिक एंड फिजिकल फिल्टर। सो इन बोथ एसपीएफ 50 एंड एसपीएफ 60 वी गेट यू नो ऑर्गेनिक एज वेल एज फिजिकल फिल्टर्स। बोथ द सनस्क्रीन हैव PA 4+ रेटिंग, मीन्स दे प्रोवाइड अ ब्रॉड स्पेक्ट्रम प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम यूवी ए रेज। बोथ द सनस्क्रीन हैव कोलिपा सर्टिफिकेशन। कोलिपा सर्टिफिकेशन इज समथिंग दैट इज अ यूरोपियन सर्टिफिकेशन दैट सनस्क्रीन अचीव फॉर हैविंग अ यू नो एम्पल अमाउंट ऑफ प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम यूवी ए रेज। जनरली द वेवलेंथ दैट दे शुड कवर इज 370 नैनोमीटर्स। नाउ दे ऑल्सो हैव बूट स्टार रेटिंग ऑफ 3। यू नो जनरली इट इज एडवाइजेबल फॉर सनस्क्रीन टू हैव बूट स्टार रेटिंग ऑफ 4, यू नो, बट दीज टू सनस्क्रीन हैव बूट स्टार रेटिंग ऑफ 3। ओके, द एसपीएफ 50 सनस्क्रीन हैज यूवीए फिल्टर ऑफ एवोबेंजोन, दैट इज अ वेरी ओल्ड फिल्टर। एंड एसपीएफ 60 हैज यूविनल ए एंड टिनोसॉब एस एज अ मेन फिल्टर फॉर यूवी ए रेज। So these are, you know, a very modern and new filter, and they are quite effective as well in preventing UVA rays. Now for UVB rays, SPF 50 has, you know, octocrylene and juvenile T150. These are very good filters and they are very new filters as well. And for SPF 60, they have juvenile T and tinosorb S again. So for UVB rays, they have ample amount of filters. But if we see that UVA filter for SPF 50 is just one, that is avibenzone, and this is quite, you know, old filter that they have used here. Now for physical filters, both the sunscreens have titanium dioxide. So this is common, and you know, titanium dioxide will complement the organic filters that are already present in both the sunscreens. Now these are the filters, right? About the multivitamins that are present in both the sunscreens, you must be wondering that what is the use of multivitamins in the sunscreen. Since multivitamins in a sunscreen complements the filter more, and you know, they prevent free radicalization, that means, you know, a causing of extended burning, causing extended pigmentations. So here these multivitamins will soothe your skin. Apart from that, these multivitamins will prevent the harm of sun rays on our skin. So this is the function of multivitamins. Basically multivitamins, you know, amplify the effect of filters in a sunscreen. So let's just check out what kind of multivitamins are used here. So multivitamins for SPF 50, they have used vitamin A, B3, 5, E and F. That is very good, and it also acts as an antioxidant, right? And for SPF 60, they have used silymarin, prevents, you know, sun rays, and it also acts as a filter as well. So you can see that silymarin is quite good as a, you know, multivitamin used. You know, commendable to use silymarin, which is obviously a little bit better, not a very substantial difference, but a little bit better from these you know, vitamins and antioxidant used in SPF 50. I think that is what you're paying for more. So the soothers are pretty much same for both the sunscreens. Both have used panthenol, sodium hyaluronate and allantoin. What does soothers do in a sunscreen, right? So what happens is, when we are facing sun rays, our skin is getting agitated, it is, you know, getting disturbed, its temperature is changing, it might cause inflammation, it might cause, you know, redness or itching. So these soothers are present to make our skin calm. So guys, in SPF 50 sunscreen there is a twist, that is retinol. You know that retinol is a very good anti-aging ingredient, but in this sunscreen sunscreen, it is not mentioned that whether this retinol is stabilized or not stabilized, what is the percentage of the retinol used. So we really can't say anything about effectiveness of retinol in this sunscreen, that whether wo humko koi anti-aging benefit provide karega ki nahi karega, we cannot say anything because it is not mentioned anywhere about the percentage specification of the retinol. Okay, so that's that. And for SPF 60, there is no retinol present. So there is a little disclaimer. If you are pregnant, please avoid SPF 50 sunscreen because it has retinol, right? So you can't take a chance, and it is generally not advisable to use a retinol in your skincare when you're pregnant. But for SPF 60 sunscreen, there is no retinol present and there are no other active present. So it is quite safe for, you know, women that are pregnant, and they can definitely go for that sunscreen. So guys, this was the comparison of both the sunscreens. I have told you in detail that what kind of filters the both sunscreens are using. So guys, moving forward in the video, let me just show you the consistency of the sunscreen I have right now with me, SPF 50 sunscreen of Minimalist. So let me just show you the packaging. This is how the packaging looks like. So guys, you can see this is a thick white cream kind of consistency this has, and right now I'm blending it on my face, and you can see that it takes a while for this product to blend in. This is a, you know, thick white cream. So guys, you have seen my skin after the application of this sunscreen, and I cannot see any kind of white cast around my face, around my nose or forehead. So I can say that, you know, it takes a little bit of effort to blend the sunscreen inside your skin, but once it is blended, you can see that it does not leave any kind of white cast, and also it is a moisturizing sunscreen because you can see my skin is not feeling very dry, and at the same time it is not feeling very much oily, right? So the consistency of these sunscreens are really great, and since they don't have zinc oxide, there is no chance of leaving them any kind of white cast, which is a very great you know, thing for the sunscreens. I think that you should go for these sunscreens. They both are very good sunscreens. You just have to decide on your budget that whether you want to go for Silymarine protection or you want to go for a multivitamin protection. But having said that, SPF 60 has some modern filters and some advanced and more water stable filters. The only thing that you should keep in mind that SPF 50 has retinol. So just, you know, if that bothers you, if you don't want to apply retinol in, you know, daytime, you're not comfortable or your skin is not comfortable, so just keep in mind this, that then you can go for SPF 60. Otherwise, both the sunscreens are, you know, quite similar in nature, you know. So just choose your sunscreen, and don't worry, both the sunscreens are good for oily skin as well. As you can see, you know, they both provide quite a matte finish, so you can choose any of both the sunscreens depending upon the ingredient list, right? So guys, let me know how you liked my review, and I'll see you in my next video, guys.